Inside of our canvas, we have a lot of different options depending on what type of element you have added to your video. So on the right hand side here, we're going to see options based on what we have inside of our canvas. So right now I have a sketch image inside of my canvas, and we have some options here. Once you have your element highlighted here and selected, we can obviously resize it by clicking and dragging any of these boxes you see, just like that there. We have this option here with these little arrows. This lets us rotate it just like that there. And we have the ability to add an animation to our sketch. So the first part is where it's going to start, the animation that you see. Then we can click this one and drag it. And as time passes by, our animation is going to go from here over to here. Okay, it's going to slide over there. And we can move this wherever we want. We can add points just like that and keep adding additional points and kind of have it do some kind of rotation around the canvas or anything like that. I'm going to click on remove points for now and keep it just like it is. On the far right hand side, for the additional options that we have, if our element is being sketched into our canvas, we can overwrite the sketch line color. Instead of black, we can make it any other color that we want to. We can flip our image vertically. We can flip it horizontally. We can scale it to match the full screen. And we can also scale it to be full screen, but to be proportional. Now for these additional options, move on top, move on bottom, move up and move down, I'm actually going to go ahead and select a different scene that we have here, which has more than one animation or sketch inside of my scene. So if I click this folder and I drag it over here, we're going to see it's on top of these people. Well, maybe I want the people to be on top of the folder. Now this comes in handy when you have text and you want the text to be overlaid on top of an image, or you want an image to be overlaid on top of a video and different things like that. So I'm going to select my folder here and I'm going to click on move down. And when I do that, we can see that the folder is now behind the people. Now if I click back and forth between move on top and move on bottom, we can see those changing inside of our timeline as well. And that's another way that we can rearrange which is on top. By simply clicking and dragging it inside of our timeline, we can change who has priority on top of the other elements. Another option that we have here inside of our canvas is the paper in the bottom right hand corner. So by default, we're going to have this plain white background inside of our canvas and inside of our video. Now, of course, we can add different images like brick images and background images and things like that. But we can also click on this paper option and we have a bunch of different textures that we can use inside of our canvas. So we can click through here and let's say I like to use this one right here. I can click on add image and that changes our white background to this new texture that we have selected. And that's the basics of the canvas that we have. We can rearrange all the different elements that we have. We can choose which ones belong on top and which ones belong on bottom. We can resize them. We can add additional elements. And when everything is good to go, all you need to do is click on close canvas, and you now have that scene prepared for your video.